Hello.
Welcome to All Essays. Reach your academic heights. My name is Julie and I will be your instructor as we read through cell phone use while driving essay. The article source is embedded in the video description below. Feel free to read along. Please note that you can get a custom, plagiarism-free essay for as little as $10 a page at All Essays. The link is in the description. While driving through the city, you see many on their cell phones while driving. When on the road, or away from our loved ones, we always want to make sure that we are in touch with them in case of an emergency. Many state that turning off your phone is key to being a safer driver. I disagree with that statement because your family needs you at any time of the day, and that is why cell phone usage should be allowed while driving. Although some say that talking on the cell phone while driving is dangerous, I disagree because talking on the cell phone is just as dangerous as turning on the radio while driving, talking to the passenger, looking at the speed limit sign, eating food, or putting on makeup while driving. Nobody wants to be told when and when not to use their own cell phone. What if you could only use your car when you were told you were able to drive it? People will refuse to be told when and when not to use their cell phones, therefore there is no way to enforce this law. Some say that talking on the cell phone while driving is dangerous. Talking on the cell phone makes you 1.3 times more likely to crash than if you were a non-distracted driver. This law should not pass because a driver that is under the influence is far more dangerous than a driver who is talking on her cell phone. Yes, there are fatalities when people are on their phones. There was 3,000 deaths due to the use of cell phones while driving, compared to the 10,000 deaths that drunk driving has caused in 1 year. Every day in America, another 28 people die as a result of drunk driving crashes. Med.org, almost every 90 seconds, a person is injured in a drunk driving crash. Med.org, enforcing a bigger issue such as drunk driving is what we should be focusing on instead of talking while driving. I would have a far more concern driving next to a drunk driver other than somebody that is talking on the cell phone rather than somebody who is drunk. Some people need to learn how to call and drive. Some are far better than others at talking while driving. Maybe we should teach this in driver's ed classes and teach people how to be safer while driving. OETSA Unregistered Trademark S100 Cars study indicated that if a driver takes his or her eyes off the road for more than 2 seconds, the risk of them crashing is greatly increases the risks of crashing. I disagree with this statement because it may make you more likely to crash, but a lot of things distract you on the road, such as a radio, food, makeup, people on the side of the road, etc. Some say that driving distracted is one of the most dangerous things that you can do, but that is wrong in my opinion. Being distracted can be dangerous, but compared to drunk driving or driving under the influence, being distracted is a very small problem. Being distracted while driving is dangerous, but in the world there are over double the fatalities as distracted driving has. We should focus more on drunk driving than distracted drivers. Also, the intensity of the call matters. If you are talking on the phone and in an intense conversation, you are twice as likely to crash the vehicle. But still, drunk driving is a lot more dangerous than talking while driving. There are some variations to the texting calling while driving law that many Americans are trying to enforce today that are somewhat reasonable and somewhat not. Turning your cell phone off and allowing calls to go to voicemail while you unregister trademark redriving is key to safer driving? This quote states that you should keep your phone off at all times while driving. I disagree with the fact that I should be told when and when not I can use my phone. For example, what if it is an emergency call and it cannot wait? All phone carriers, Verizon, Sprint, T-Mobile, etc. need to have a driver's mode setting on their phone, I think. The driver's mode would work like this: if a family member or an emergency contact calls you more than once, the call will go through, but if they only call you once, the call will be stopped. This is one great alternative to saving lives on the road without taking away the privilege of using your cell phone while driving. People in America will respond better to this new law instead of rebellious actions from the community. Letting drivers know laws will be enforced has been developed to enforce drunk driving, speeding, seatbelts, etc. Yes, I agree that trying to enforce the cell phone law will help prevent crashes, but how do you enforce this law? By talking to the phone carriers to put a driver's mode on every cell phone in America is the best way to enforce this rule. Sometimes you need to take important phone calls while you unregister trademark re in the car, That is why this law should not be enforced. There are many times in the car when you do not need to take phone calls, surf the web, text your friends while driving. Doing this kind of stuff while driving is bad and dangerous. That is why many phone companies should have the driver's mode setting on their phone devices. There are many fatalities every year in texting, and driving is not the main thing we need to be focusing on. Thank you for taking your time to listen to me. I hope you enjoyed learning about cell phone use while driving essay as much as I did. Kindly remember that you can get a custom, plagiarism-free essay at LSAs for as little as $10. The link is in the description. See you next time.